Wayne Sage says, why is Eddie...
So what does it matter then?
Hold on, Ty. Wayne Sage says, why is Eddie starting over Lacazette? Eddie just isn't good enough. He's not Premier League quality.
Right.
He can't dribble, can't create, can't hold a ball up. Why? Some of the defending today.
Yeah,
shocking. Rick Akesh says, our only hope of not being relegated this season is hoping that Fulham, West Brom and Sheffield United and Brighton lose all their games.
Oh, no. I don't believe that.
We're kind of lucky that they're that bad at the moment. Mm. Or we'd be even in a worse situation. VK says, we can ask Ty why does he believe we are not in a relegation fight?
Because I don't.
Ty, we're in a relegation fight.
I don't think we are.
This is no joke now. We're in a relegation fight.
I'm deadly serious, because I don't.
Manchild says, DT wants to compare Arteta to Unai Emery. He says, DT wants to compare Arteta to Unai Emery. One was a qualified winning manager. The other was a coach, that's all. Get a grip, step back and see it as how it is. And I think he makes a good point there.
He's not making a good point.
He is.
Because he spent some money and put a super chat, he don't make a good point.
He's making
he's
a good
point. He's a fucking not.
He's making a
because
good point.
Because when have I compared fucking Arteta
you have.
And fucking him?
You have. You have.
Fucking haven't, man.
You have
people
compared.
People piss me off. No, you it's other people
it.
That compare him.
You've got to be able
other,
to take criticism.
Other people that compare
you've
him
got to be able to take
and
criticism.
Mention my fucking name.
You've got to
fuck
be able to take
off.
Criticism. That's your problem. You see, he's stuck his neck out. He's broke his phone. He's stuck his neck out.
Digging at me. Constant.
Who's
fuck
digging?
Off.
You've got to be able to take criticism.
Fuck off.
At the end of the day, for me,
no
Mikel Arteta at the moment, you have to. If you're going to defend him, I want to hear somebody defend him. I want to hear somebody defend him properly. Not just tell me that, oh, yeah, no,
Robbie,
it ain't his fault. I want to hear a reason.
Robbie,
Leave one second. I want to hear a reason why this manager at the moment, yeah, who's managing Arsenal Football Club, who's sitting in 15th in a serious problem of getting relegated,
no.
defend him and tell me why he should be in a job. Don't just shout. Give me the reasons.
I need to say this because he has defended the manager, right? Yeah,
so
he has defended the manager, right? And at the end of the day, it's not Arteta that's let him down, right? What he's done is he's backed the manager, but the players, the whole club, have let him down. And he can't, you know,
players.
Well, at the end of the day, why can't you turn around and say, I've got it wrong?
Lee, I don't want to hear this players thing, yeah? Of course the players are letting him down at the moment. But when he won the FA Cup, right? Everybody was big up Arteta. Even me included. Big him up because you big him up because he's won it. Now things are going bad. You're still in charge. You're still in charge of those same players. Mm. So you've got to take blame as well. You can't just then now all of a sudden, it's nothing to do with me, it's the players.
Yeah, no, that's true. That's
right.
True.
Then we're loading you up and we're saying, oh, you know what?
That's
hey, he got the best out of these players. He won the FA Cup. But you've made, let me tell you with Arteta, he's made some big decisions. Ozil, bringing in Willian, all these things are his. Even today. Yeah.
Even when
that's the Kroenke hasn't rung him and told him to leave Willian on the pitch.
Because you've backed
Kroenke
him.
Kroenke hasn't rung him before the game and said start Eddie Nketiah.
Listen, because you've backed the manager.
You're in charge.
Right, because you've backed the manager, right, it doesn't mean after a result like that you can't change your mind. Of course you can. If you call the flip-flop and that, it's about results. It's a results business. Mm. If we was winning 5, 6 or 7 games, I'm sure the people that wanted Arteta out would be changing there and saying what a great manager he is. Yeah? But the fact of the matter is, it's gone the other way. So as a football fan, as a supporter of a football club, I am entitled to change my opinion.
Of course you're entitled to change your opinion.
And so is that. So at the end of the day, it does not make him any worse of a man whether he turns round today and says that that manager is not good enough.
Of course.
And that is what he's got to do. It's no problem him to come out today and say, do you know what? He's not good enough.
What of course, you've got to be able to
not
be...
Not worry what other people say.
Really, I need to control him.
My name's not Mikel Arteta, right? My name's not Stan Kroenke, yeah?
Just
I'm just an Arsenal fan. Yeah, I want Mikel Arteta to succeed.
Well,
but at this moment in time, right, I see our club where we are. And I just got to tell it as it is.
Mm. Robbie,
At this moment in time, if I was looking at another club, say this was Manchester United or this was Chelsea, yeah. I was looking at any of those clubs in this trouble, I'd be saying to my mates, you should get rid of that guy. He's not good enough.
Definitely.
Right? So as much as I want to be loyal to my manager, I want to be loyal to my football club, the truth of the matter is, right, I'm just trying to be honest here, right? This is not good enough.
I have friends who tell me, from Chelsea fans, Liverpool fans, tell me, yo, we need to get rid of Arteta. Arteta's problem. So the job is too big. The club is too big for him.
Vivek says the problem is the, both the manager and the players.
Of course it is.
Arteta might someday become a good manager, but he has no experience in handling relegation form. Come summer, we need to clean out half of the squad. And just because you've nailed yourself to something,